Stand now and let it be known. too. Let's all say amen if you have it.
Amen.
The first, from the first to the sixth verse.
All right.
Now we do you boast in evil, O mighty man. The goodness of God endures continuously. Your tongue devises destruction. Like a sharp razor worketh deceitfulness. Verse 3. You love evil more than good, lying rather than speaking righteousness. You love all devouring words, you deceitful tongue. Verse 5. God shall likewise destroy you forever. He shall take you away and pluck you out of your dwelling place and uproot you from the land of the living. Verse 6. And the righteous also shall see and fear and shall laugh at him, saying. Verse 7. Here is the man who did not make God his strength, but trust in the abundancy of his riches and strengthen himself in his wickedness. But I am like the green olive tree in the house of God.
Yes, Lord.
I trust in the mercy of God, however, forever and ever.
Yes.
I will praise you forever.
Yes.
Because you have done it, excuse me, and in the presence of your saints, I will wait on your name, for it is good.
Amen.
May the Lord have blessed to us.
Okay. Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
When you can go up to prison and somebody say, you know, I was having a conversation, it's like the person was looking for somebody to say something bad about me.
Yeah.
Say something right there. You know, that person had nothing. I just said,
yeah.
Yeah. You know, whatever it is, you know, get up and shake. Thank you.
Joaquin, my man. I mean, they're beautiful names, but there's no other name like the name Jesus. I said there's no other name like the name Jesus. When you're down and out, that name can lift you up. It was in the name of Jesus that you got baptized. It was in the name of Jesus that you got filled with the Holy Ghost. It was at the name of Jesus that God delivered you from sin. Amen. Hallelujah. There's something about that name. And you know what? You don't have to scream it. You don't have to yell it. You can just say Jesus. He hears it. Amen. And you know what I like about calling on that name? You can call him in the morning. You can call him in the noonday. You can call him in the midnight hour. He ain't gonna put you on hold like some of us do. Or can I call you back in a little while? He's always there to answer your call. Amen? Something about that name. Amen? You call on the name of Jesus and things have to move. Things get out of your way. Hallelujah. Things just seem like they get small. Amen? Where it looked like it was impossible for you to go through. After you call on Jesus, seems like you can go over a mountain. Amen? You can speak to that mountain and say, move, and it'll move. Amen? Hallelujah. Use what you got, saints. You got the name of Jesus. Use it. Amen? Hallelujah. It can move anything that's in your way. Any obstacle, any test or trial you're going through, if you just call on Jesus, amen? I've used it so many times, and it works every time, every different way, in every situation, amen? Hallelujah. He's never failed me yet. The song said, yet, but he said he'll never fail. He told Peter, I prayed for you, that your faith fail you not. Not that you wouldn't fall sometimes. Not that you wouldn't get disappointed sometimes. Not that you wouldn't get hurt sometimes. But I pray that your faith fail you not. Hold on to your faith, saints, amen. Hold on to your faith. Because the faith is what God uses to rescue you, to pull you back up, amen. Hold on to the faith. Hallelujah. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. He's a God of faith. All he said was let. And it was so. Amen? If we only knew what we had. If we only knew how to use the tools that God has given us. Then life would be so easy. So much easier. Amen? I ain't gonna say you ain't gonna go through nothing and you ain't gonna hurt. Yeah, you're gonna go through some things. Because only the pain can cause a change. Amen? God can't help us if he let us be happy and feel good all the time. Can't change nothing, you know? We'd be happy-go-lucky, amen? We wouldn't see no need to pray, come to church, you know? God giving us everything and making us happy all the time. But he knows that pain is what causes us to change. And we go through it, don't we? Job said, man that is born of a woman is of a few days and is full of trouble, amen? So when you get your joy, you better hold on to it as long as you can. And enjoy that joy, amen? Because as sure as you got joy, trouble is on the way. Amen? God ain't giving you that joy for nothing. He's strengthening you through that joy. So when you come to church, you should try to get all the joy that you can. Because the joy of the Lord is your strength. Amen? Not me saying something to you. The joy of the Lord is your strength. So we should never come to church and not praise our God. Because he's worthy of all the glory. He's worthy of all the praise. Hallelujah. And he's totally worthy of all the honor. Hallelujah. You know where he brought you from. You know what you have been through. Hallelujah. And don't tell me I ain't going to praise my God. Oh, yes, I am. Hallelujah. You've been too good. Hallelujah. Or it's just to sit back and kind of wave our hand. Amen. I'm going to just wave my hand. My hallelujah belongs to him. My thank you, Jesus, belongs to him. the afternoon announcements, amen? Praise the Lord, saints. There will be a Palm Sunday fellowship dinner after service on next Sunday. All are welcome. Let's fellowship in love, amen? That'll be here at the church in the dining room, amen? And all y'all who don't know, I'm going to tell you, you don't want to miss it, because we got some good cooks here, great Christian ministry. Amen? Amen. There's three of them sitting right there. Them sisters can cook. Amen. She made just a simple little yogurt parfait, and that thing was so good after service. And you know, I went back and ate it, and I said, oh, this is good. It was really good. Amen. So we got the best cooks here. Amen. So the plan to stay next Sunday. Amen. And fellowship with the saints. Eat dinner with us. Amen. Amen. And these are our scheduled services. On Wednesday, we have Bible class at 6 p.m. And Pastor been teaching some real good Bible classes. Oh, y'all just don't. You just ought to come. Amen. Sister Tamika and Sister Shalanda, they come and they just enjoy themselves. I sit back and join you and them. I sit back and I just enjoy hearing them rejoicing in the Lord. Amen. The rest of us don't have to say nothing. I mean, we be trying, but they be so overpowering us, you know. You better tell it. You better free up. Yeah. That's right, Pastor. That's right. But that's the way we all should be. Amen. 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 Let's not let them shut us out anymore. Amen. Let's get behind Pastor and push him too. Amen. Amen. But them two sisters to be pushing them. I know those things, amen. And when if I get up there, I want y'all to push me too like that, girls. Amen. Y'all make the Holy Ghost talk. Amen. Amen. How many know you're supposed to give 10% of all your increases and tithes? And God said he would open up the windows and pour you out a blessing. You would have room enough to receive it. Amen. Amen. And your offering is a love offering. You know, it tells God that I appreciate what you've done for me, what you're doing for me, and what you're going to do for me. Amen. Amen. This morning I learned in Sunday school that each offering has a different assignment in your life. Amen. Amen. So you want to pay your tithes and you definitely want to pay your offering. Amen. Amen. God is good to us. All right, I'm going to ask everyone. Take your fingers. Father, we come before you in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you for the opportunity to give one more time, Lord. So into your kingdom, Lord. What a pleasure in Jesus' name. We ask, Lord, that you bless this offering. And build up Christian ministries, Lord. Let it be a saving station in Erie. Asking, Lord, that you'll bless our bishop, bless our first lady, and bless this offering, Lord, for the building up of your kingdom. In Jesus' mighty name and for Christ's sake. Amen. Ask everyone to stand, please, and come to the center of the aisle. The usher will be ready. Lord, you are awesome.
Hallelujah. and praise God for serving you. Amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. It is truly good to be back in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I enjoy being in the house of the Lord. I enjoy praising Him. I enjoy giving the Lord thanks, for He is good. I said, He is good, and His mercy endureth forever. And every time I think about what the Lord has done, amen, He's done something better. He's done something else that makes me say, Lord, I thank you. Amen. Hallelujah. The Lord will make a way. I said, the Lord will make a way. Won't He heal your body? Won't He deliver your soul? Won't He give you joy and sorrow? Come on, give the Lord a praise. Don't you have a peace that passes all understanding? Won't you open up the windows of God and tell you a blessing that you are not beautiful enough to receive? You ought to give God a praise. I said, hallelujah. Hallelujah, anyhow. I said, it's hallelujah, anyhow. When the storms of life are raging, it's hallelujah, anyhow. Hallelujah, when I'm baptized and angry, sleep, it's hallelujah, anyhow. Hallelujah, anyhow. Because I know that one day the storm is going to pass over. I know that one day the sun is going to shine. Hallelujah. I know that the Lord is good. Tell you that the Lord is good, and His mercy endureth forever. Amen. My time is getting away from me. Thank you, Jesus. But it's good to praise God. Amen. Hallelujah. Believe it or not, I started out as a praise and worship leader. I was self-appointed. The pastor didn't tell me to get up. The people didn't tell me to get up. I said, I'm going to get up and praise God. Hallelujah. And you know, y'all know I can't sing. And I said, Lord, I can't sing. And the Lord said, I ain't tell you to sing. I told you to make a joyful noise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I don't mind praising Him. I said, I don't mind praising Him. Thank you, Jesus. And God is good, and His mercy endures forever. So we praise God that He has blessed us all to come here on today to be together one more time. Amen. It's good for the saints to come together. It's good for the people of God to come together. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I'm glad when I hear your testimonies. I'm glad when I see your lovely faces. And we certainly do give honor to God and our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and bless our lovely wife, Lady Tracy Quinn. Thank God for her. Amen. We thank God for Pastor Doug and Evangelist Arrington. Amen. Thank you. And she got an anointing on her as well. I thank God for that. Minister Grady, we praise God for our deacons. Amen. Deacon Phil, Deacon Daniels, praise God for all of you. Our media team that is up there, our ushers. Amen. Thank God for Sister Mona and her body, for her husband and her boys being here today. Amen. Thank God for them. Amen. I praise God for each and every one of you. Amen. We thank God for those that have done great things, and those that have come to be in the house of the Lord one more time. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank God for Brother Leroy and Sister Chris being back, and the walls being back. Amen. Come on, hallelujah. Thank God for my brother, Minister Sylvester Quinn. Amen. God pray for him. Left his medication back in Altoona, so he feeling a little sluggish here. Amen. But the Lord will see him through. Yep. I'm used to him up shouting and screaming and stuff. Thank you, Lord, but I pray that the Lord will touch his body. Amen? Amen. We certainly pray. Amen. And before we get into the word, I just want to give a praise report. We certainly do thank God We got that occupancy permit for the daycare, and I sent the And God seemed like he was trying to hold on to it. Lord said, give him a call. So I called him up, and he had it here the next day. Amen. God is good. All we got to do is be obedient to the Holy Ghost. I didn't call him up, cuss him out. I didn't tell him off. I just said, hey, what's going on? He said, oh, okay. You got church over there. I said, yeah, it's all right. I'll drop it off tomorrow. I said, okay, amen. And he did what he said. Amen. So we thank God for that. We also thank God once again. It's a historic day for us. On Friday, I sent off that application to the state. Amen. So I'm looking forward to the state's licensure. And then once we get that, we can open our doors. Amen. Come on, give God a praise. Thank you. We certainly praise God. And when they told me on yesterday they want to have a dinner, that just made my soul excited. Amen. Saints going to be fellowshipping again. Amen. That's a good thing. And I ain't mad at you if you grab and go. They don't want you to grab and go. They want you to sit down just for a minute. You know, but if you grab and go, I ain't going to be mad. Thank you, Lord. So we thank God. We thank God. Amen. And it's going to we're moving into Palm Sunday. We're moving into Palm Sunday on next week. So that means that we're going to celebrate Jesus. We celebrate him every day, but we're going to celebrate Jesus in his triumphant entry into Jerusalem. And then you know that following week is Good Friday. So we're going to be having communion service on that Friday. Friday is a high day. So come, prepare yourself for communion. We want the brothers to wear black and white. We want the sisters to wear white. Amen. And come, come so we can have communion together. It'd be our first communion here in this holy sanctuary. So let us come. Let us prepare ourselves. And if you need to talk to Pastor Quinn, you know, give me a call. Call me up. And we can communicate. If you want to talk to Pastor Duck and any one of these five ministers, amen, feel free. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. That's a good thing. Amen? Thank you, Jesus. So let us come. Let us come to prepare ourselves. And our communion service will start on Friday, Good Friday, at 6 o'clock. And we'll be fasting. Let me back up. Communion service will start at 7 o'clock, and we'll be fasting from Thursday at midnight till 4 p.m. Friday. Amen? Friday. So that we can prepare ourselves and get ourselves together, because that's the Lord's holy table, and we want to be able to discern the body and the blood. Thank you, Lord. We want to have a good time. A good time in the Lord. So as we prepare ourselves for this Holy Week, and then what happens 50 days after Easter? Pentecost, day of Pentecost. I forgot about Easter. Can't forget about Easter. Then that following Sunday after Good Friday, it's going to be Easter time. Amen. Where we celebrate the death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord and Savior. And then 50 days after that, we're going to celebrate Pentecost. Pentecost Sunday. So we got a lot of things to celebrate. Amen? Amen. Thank you, Lord. So let the church stand. Let the church stand. Amen. You know, the Lord told me to bring my Bible out here. And as you know, I forgot about it. That ain't good, is it? That ain't good. Yeah, let me see. Let me see. Thank you, Jesus. Just be something honorable when you give up your sword in battle. Somebody can use it. Come on, give God a praise, man. Hallelujah. Let us turn to the book of St. Luke. See, I got Evangelist Arrington over there. She take me in. She take me in. Thank you, Lord. we certainly do thank God for that testimony that she had, because jail is a dark and gloomy place. And when you can let your light shine, amen, and they see the God in me, amen. They don't see me. I let the light shine. And I thank God. I give God praise for it. Amen. No credit. No credit to Frank. All the glory belongs to God. Amen. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Because if it was left up to me, I'd be in there with them. A lot of us would. Thank you, Jesus. Good shot. But if it had not been for the Lord on our side, where would we be? Come on and give the Lord one more praise. Let us go to the Lord in the book of St. Luke, chapter number 11. And drop down to verse number 5. I'm sorry. Let's look at verse number 1. And it says, and it came to pass that as he was praying in a certain place, when he ceased, one of his disciples said unto him, Lord, teach us to pray, as John taught his disciples. And he said unto them, when ye pray, say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done, as in heaven, so in earth. He said, give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, for we also forgive everyone that is indebted to us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Verse number 5. And he said unto them, which of you shall have a friend, and shall go unto him at midnight, and say unto him, Friend, lend me 3 loaves, for a friend of mine is in his journey, is come to me, and I have nothing to set before him. Verse 7. And he from within shall answer and say, Trouble me not, the door is now shut, and my children are with me in bed. I cannot rise and give thee. I say unto you, though he will not rise and give him, because he is his friend, but yet because of his importunity, he will rise and give him as many as he needed. My God. And I say unto you, ask, and it shall be given you. Seek, and ye shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. For everyone that asketh, and he that seeketh, and to him that knocketh, it shall be opened. Tell your neighbor, it shall be. It shall be. Oh, gracious Father, in the name of Jesus, we come before you, Lord, to say thank you for your word on today. We thank you, Lord, for moving in this atmosphere. We thank you, Lord, for increasing our level of faith. We thank you, Lord, for being merciful unto us, to allow us to assemble together one more time to hear your holy word. We ask you, Lord, that you condition our hearts, that we may receive it with meekness, the engrafted word of God to the saving of our soul. Lord, we ask you to heal the few sick among us, strengthen our hearts, bless us, Lord, physically, financially, and most of all, spiritually, that we might be able to stand. Hallelujah, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you and praise you in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. And I want to take for a subject the Lord is actively moving. And he wants me to change the subject to it shall be. And I tell you, neighbor, it shall be. It shall be. All you gotta do is ask, and it shall be. Just ask, and it shall be. When we were studying this particular chapter here, and this particular verse, I was quite intrigued by the fact that Jesus' disciples asked him, Lord, teach us how to pray. And what made me intrigued by that was the fact that they knew that it was important to pray. He said, teach us how to pray, just as John the Baptist taught his disciples how to pray. It's important to be able to open your heart up, to be able to receive instruction on how to pray. If you don't pray right, you'll ask amiss. If you don't pray right, you'll pray for things that you want to consume, the Bible says, upon your own lust, upon your own desires. And the Bible says that we have not because we ask not. And if we ask amiss, you won't receive it. So Jesus took it upon himself and begins to open up their understanding about prayer. He first of all gave them a model on how to pray. He gave them the Our Father who art in heaven. Hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done in earth as it is in heaven. First, Jesus was teaching them that we are connected to a kingdom. You've got to realize that you're under the authority of someone that belongs to a holy kingdom. This holy kingdom is governed by a holy God who is supervised by a holy Savior. So we must then condition our own hearts on how to walk by faith and not by sight so that we can please the God that we serve. The Bible says, faith cometh by hearing, and that by the word of God. The scripture tells us that faith now is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not seen. And it goes on to say, without faith, it's impossible to please your God. And if you ask God in faith, all things are possible. All things are possible. So we belong to a king. We're in a kingdom and we belong to a king. And the scripture that identifies this king as the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. There's nobody like our king. Nobody came to you like Jesus. Nobody came to you like the Lord. He's gracious, he's merciful, he's all powerful, he's all knowing, and he's able to save you to the uttermost. He's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. So how are we to live, the Bible says, under this authority of this great King? So we must first, the Bible says, seek first the kingdom of God and his righteousness. We can't seek cars, we can't seek houses, we can't seek land. We gotta first seek the kingdom. We gotta seek the kingdom of God and his righteousness. And he said, all these other things that you desire shall be added unto you. In other words, when you gain the victory, Pastor Duck was saying that Jesus prayed for Peter. He said, the devil has desired to sift you as wheat. But notice what he said, but Peter, I prayed for you. I prayed that your faith will not fail. And then he said, when thou art converted, when thou art changed, when thou art sanctified, then thou shalt strengthen thy brother. You can't go out to cars and houses and land and not have Jesus on your side, because all those things will suck you away from the Lord. All those things will cause you to be weak as desert dust if you put your trust in your riches, if you put your trust in the things that man seeks after. But if you put your trust in Jesus, if you put your trust in the Lord, not just some things, but everything. Take a neighbor, everything. is going to be all right. So we got to seek first the Lord. We got to seek him. We got to seek his kingdom. And then the Bible tells you that once you seek the Lord, that he's going to give you some power. He's going to give you some power. He's going to give you some anointing. The Bible says that he shall receive power after that the Holy Ghost has come upon you. But God wants to give you some power so that you can be able to possess your vessel in sanctification and in honor. God wants to give you some power so that you know how to walk worthy of the vocation wherewith you are called. As Evangelist Arrington said earlier today, that a good name is to be honored more than riches and gold. And the Holy Ghost gives you that power on you to walk in a good name. The Holy Ghost gives you that authority so that you can be able to possess your body, so that you can be able to love right, so that you can be able to do right, so that you can be able to glory. I need to be not conformed, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Tell your neighbor, I gotta be transformed. I gotta have this Holy Ghost. I gotta have the anointing. I gotta have some power. I gotta have some faith. And he told his disciples that you've got to seek God. that you've got to ask and that you've got to knock. My brothers and sisters, we have to recognize the importance of prayer. We've got to recognize the importance of having a prayer life. If you want to be conformed to this world, don't have a prayer life. But if you want to be transformed by renewing of your mind, you've got to spend some time with the Master. You've got to spend some time with the Savior. You've got to spend some time with the lily of the valley and with the bright and morning star. If you want to be transformed, you've got to let the Lord get into your mind, and it gets into your mind through prayer. Tell your neighbor, I've got to pray. The Bible says that men should always pray and not faint, because you've got an adversary, the adversary of the devil, and he comes to kill, steal, and to destroy. I'm sure that you're sitting here today because the adversaries all around us have had some wicked thoughts. I'm sure the devil here today has tried to influence you in a wicked way, in a negative way. So that's why you've got to have a lifestyle of prayer. You've got to be able to go before the Lord and be able to concentrate yourself before the Lord. And the prayer, and like every other prayer, there's sometimes when you pray, you don't feel nothing. You don't hear nothing. But you can say, Lord, I was there. But then some other times, when you pray, you manifest himself. You manifest his glory. You pour out an anointing. You change your atmosphere. You change your situation. Sometimes when you pray, you send you a word. It can just be one word. Stand. And when it tells you to stand, all you gotta do is stand. Sometimes you'll send your words and tell you to wait. And if you wait upon the Lord, God will give the courage. He'll strengthen your heart. Come on and give God a praise. Give God a praise. Give God a praise. Oh, brothers and sisters, what Jesus was teaching, he was teaching about the importance of prayer. You've got to recognize that the enemy, the devil, Beelzebub, Snoop-footed, he don't want you to pray, because he knows that when the saints begin to pray, the Lord can begin to have his way. When you, the saints, begin to pray, the blessings of the Lord, they can come down. When you begin to pray, you get the mind of Christ. When you begin y'all need to sleep. I'm done. Y'all got the message. What are we going to do? What are we going to do? Pray without ceasing. What are we going to do? And pray without convenience. What are we going to do? Pray without commotion. Pray without labor. Be steadfast. When you pray for those that come up against you, you won't criticize them. You'll pray for them. God, when you pray for your enemy, get ready for God to add against you. When you pray for those that hate you and despise you,
in your prayer, cast all your cares upon him. If
He wants you to knock and keep on knocking. Amen? Now sometimes, I'm done preaching. Sometimes, I hope I'm done. Sometimes, Minister Brady. Sometimes, Minister Quinn. Sometimes, Pastor Doug. What we're asking for doesn't come right away. Am I right? But then, we got to realize that God is trying your faith. Amen? Because in your patience, you possess your what? Soul. So God is building up patience within you. And you've got to allow patience to have her what? Perfect work. Let patience build up tolerance in you. Let patience build up endurance in you. Let patience build up self-control in you. So that you'll be able to possess that which God wants to bestow upon you. Because he won't withhold no good thing for you. But he's got to get you ready for the blessing. He's got to get you ready for the next level. He's got to get you ready for the breakthrough. So you got to wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Wait on the Lord. Tell your neighbor, wait on the Lord. If you wait on the Lord, he'll give you what you ask, but you got to wait on him. Amen? He's got to build you up for it. And while he's building you up for it, you got to have patience. Amen? Hallelujah. Your daughter or your son, they get their license, get them a permit, you get their pass, their license. You don't just run out and buy them a Cadillac. You don't run out and buy them a Hummer. You don't run out and buy them a Benz. You get them a hoopty. You get them a hoopty. And you ought to let them back that up a couple of times so they'll be able to appreciate it when they move to the next level. Hallelujah. If your God being much wiser than you are, if your God has more understanding than you have, hallelujah, will he not withhold a good thing from you? Oh no, he will bless you in due season. Tell your neighbor, I'm waiting on my season. Tell your neighbor, come on, stop. Somebody tell somebody, now is my season. Now is my time. Now is the time. I come on, stop. For God to open up the windows of heaven. Now is the time for God to pour you out blessings. Tell somebody the storm has passed over. Hallelujah. Anyhow, let the church stand. Oh, see, Pastor Jeff, she got me. Because I feel a whole other preach coming on. Hey, come on, give God a praise. Give God a praise. We was in prayer Friday night, and it was different from the prayer that we had last Friday night. This last Friday night, we had to push a little bit to get through to the throne. This Friday night, the Lord met us. The Lord met us. The Lord met us. And those that were there could literally confess that the Lord did something. That the Lord moved something. That the Lord caused something to happen. The Lord spoke to me. And he said, it's time. It's our season. It's our season. It's our season. That God is about to explode up in here. That God is about to make a move up in here. And I'm looking for God to do. I'm looking for God to make that move. I'm looking for God to open up that window. And it don't matter if people don't believe. It don't matter if people don't trust. He told me, and I believe. I'm trusting in God. I'm opening up my eyes. I'm praising him for the blessing. I'm praising him for the anointing. I'm praising him for the healing. I'm praising him for the Tell somebody it's my time. It's my season. It's my time. It's my season. The wait is over. The wait is over. You don't have to wait till the battle is over. You can shout right now. You can praise them right now. You can give God a thank you right now. You can have double shout. Hey, hallelujah. You can praise your God right now. You can give God thanks right now. Hallelujah. Give him a faith praise. Come on, just give him a faith praise. Give God a faith praise. I don't see it, but I believe it.
But the Lord just dropped it on my heart.
We got issues at home. We got issues on our job. We got issues all around us. Even in our church, we got issues. Amen. If for the next 30 days you give the Lord those issues, you'll come here with a testimony. And you'll say, who did it? Who did it? Who did it? And you'll shout. Oh, come on, shout. You'll shout around this church. And you'll believe your God. Hallelujah. And you'll see him move on your behalf. That's a mandate standing behind this sacred desk. Hallelujah. That came from the Lord. Hallelujah. Come on and give God a praise. Don't you just shout. Hallelujah. Amen. I learned from my African brother that when God does something for you, you just give him a praise. When God reveals something to you, you just give him a praise. Amen. Soon, we're going to come to this altar and just praise God, but it's coming. Amen. Amen. I already gave the benediction. See, I feel like preaching again. I don't want to let y'all go. Amen. So I'm just going to put down this mic. Come on, give God one more praise.